Here we'll have a look at some shots of the microorganisms that were extracted and multiplied in the mini-microbulator, the 5-gallon unit, made for use with a Home Depot 5-gallon pail or facsimile. This is at the beginning stages when it's primarily bacteria. There's a ciliate whizzing around. And earlier we saw a flagellate, and there's another one up in the left corner. Oops. Later on, after the 24-hour, there's another flagellate that's extracted. They generally don't begin multiplying until the 36-hour period, or in between 24 and 36. Which is what this is now. And we're just taking a run right across one cover slip, which is a fairly typical way of having a look at the microorganisms that you've developed in your extrapolation or compost tea. You can see that there are quite a number of flagellates now, having divided in response to the bacterial levels. And there is some fungal hypha, although encrusted with bacteria and organic matter. Lots of times when people say to look for at least two flagellates per field of view, lots of times you don't see any for a period, and then bang, you see a whole pile like this. And there's some more fungal hypha, also pretty coated with bacteria and organic matter, but it's a good place for the flagellates to feed. I should point out that The flagellates are often feeding on bacteria that are smaller than what we really can see with this level of microscopy or magnification. Later on, I think we'll see something that shows them up a little bit better. Fungal hypha there. And another arm of the same fungal hypha complex. Zoomed out a little too far. And as we go along, there's more fungal hypha, not so coated as the others. Anyway, as I was saying, as we go along, we'll be passing some odds and sods, blips and blops, and some of them could well be naked amoeba. We'll go back and look at those closely later, and that I just focused on is just a flaw in the glass. You have to buy super expensive cover slips to avoid those. You can see some of those dark spots in the back. There are they could be a bacterial structure or naked amoeba. But watching naked amoeba is like watching ice melt, as you'll see. And there's some more fungal hypha. Okay, so here is an air bubble. And it's a very good place to see the organisms congregating. That big one zooming around there is a ciliate. you don't want to see a whole pile of those, but a few of them are no problem. They are indicators that there could be a top load of anaerobic bacteria, because that's their favorite food, apparently. So if you look here, you can see that with the air bubble, that a lot of bacteria congregate to it, and so you can sort of see the tinier bacteria because they're all together, and it's also a good indicator that they are actually aerobic bacteria because they're attracted to the air. In the top, going just about going off the screen, is flagellate dividing. So right there in front of your eyes, one is becoming two. We really don't have enough time to watch it come to total fruition, and sometimes the sample actually dries up before that occurs. The long strands that you see, the long skinny black strands, some moving, some not, those are bacteria. Yeah, it's quite a dance when they when they're dividing. And there you can see that there are a variety of flagellates, not a huge variety, but there's at least two different species or genotypes anyway. Probably more, but to be on the safe side, I'd say two. And here's a close-up of a flagellate, which appears to be feeding. I don't think you can actually see bacteria going into it, but it certainly seems to be using its flagellum to bring bacteria into itself. And as a sample has sat for a long time, it heats up, and the liquid gets thinner, and the organisms the image is more enhanced. You can see have a closer look at some of the weird shapes that the flagellates are. And there's some fungal hypha complex, fairly large one. just guessing, I would estimate this to be between 4 and 6 microns in diameter. And here's a naked amoeba that I said we would have a look at, and it is like watching ice melt. You have to watch closely to see that they're moving. There's one right in the center, oozing. That's how they move, is by oozing. You can see the size of them. There's a bacterium swimming past. And there's another one left of center. And those long rods are stationary bacteria, and there's a chain style bacterium or bacterial structure to the right. Of course, surrounded by moving flagellates. And another in the center. Naked amoeba range in size from very tiny to very large. And one more. Thank you for watching.